excited. The 8 best in the world are going at it.
The 48th Artistic Gymnastics World Championships came to a close today with 5 more individual apparatus titles decided. The action began on men's vault, where the Olympic champion Risei Gwang went head-to-head with defending world champion Kenzo Shirai. Once again, Risei Gwang put out the 2 most difficult vaults of the final, with huge 6.0 difficulty values, both with his name attached to them. The first was a handspring double front with half turn in the pike position. With height and flight, he secured the landing to score 14.933. He achieved exactly the same score for his second vault, the full twisting double Sukihara in the tuck position. He required a little readjustment on landing, but it was a small price to pay in terms of execution, given the complexity of the vault. In the end, it was a 3rd world title to add to his Olympic gold. This is the Sukihara. With less than 0.5 between all qualifiers, it was always going to be close. In the end, it was the final performer, Artur Delaloyan from the Russian Federation, our all-around champion, who clinched the silver. Scoring 14.866 for this triple twist in Yurchenko, he was off to a very good start.
Here's the round up. Pops it up. 3 twists. 3.
He did not hold back on his second vault. With acceleration, power, thrust and precision, he controlled this huge handspring double front in the pike position to score 14.9 and an average of 14.883. Delaloyan had secured his 4th medal of the championship.
Double salto forward pike, that's called the plan.
Kenzo Shirai had to settle for bronze, whilst Great Britain's Dominic Cunningham just missed out, following very closely behind in 4th place.
And if you think about it, we started
the women's beam final came next, with the leader from qualification, Simone Biles, being drawn first on the start list. She was joined by Olympic champion Sanne Vevers, along with Kara Eker, the 2nd highest qualifier. Within a final fraught with errors and filled with falls from experienced performers, it was the final competitor, 18-year-old Liu Tingting, who kept calm and composed when it mattered. Her beautiful amplitude, demonstrated in both the acrobatic and dance elements, led to minimal execution deductions and a score of 14.533. When she realised the world title was hers, the emotion was plain to see. Tears of joy to accompany her world gold. Another youngster, 16-year-old Anne-Marie Padurario from Canada, seemed to surprise herself with her outstanding exercise. Making her debut at a senior world championships, she was unfazed by the enormity of the occasion and settled into the rhythm of her routine excellently. She included the very difficult aerial cartwheel layout-layout combination and led the competition until the very last performance with a score of 14.1. Padurario was thrilled with her silver medal. In the end, and even with faults, Simone Biles won another medal, this time bronze with 13.6. Here are the rest of the results.
A very quick final indeed.
The parallel bars featured an exciting start list, including reigning world champion and Olympic champion, along with the new all-around champion. Zhu Jinghuan appears to have taken this apparatus to another level. He has almost reinvented his routine, filling it with unparalleled flight, fluidity, technical excellence and extension. It was an impeccable performance, and he was in another class amongst finalists who were all of an exceptional standard. With a faultless dismount, he scored an incredible 16.433 to defend his world title with ease. Ukraine's Olympic champion, Oleg Verniaev, was very happy with his silver medal in the end, while Staloyan picked up his fifth medal of the championships, this time the bronze. Yet again, Mikulak found himself just out of the medals in agonising fourth place. The final event for women was Floor. Amongst the contenders, Olympic champion Biles, defending world champion Murakami, and Angelina Melnikova from Russia, who had won the Longines Prize for Excellence. Brilliant Biles once again entertained the spectators and judges with her dynamic and difficult tumbling, her unique choreography, and her personal charm. Starting with a double twisting double straight, including her own double straight half to stag jump, and finishing with a double double in the tuck position, she scored 14.933. Even with a step out of the area, it was still a full mark ahead of the silver medalist. So a fourth world title for Biles, and what a comeback. She has medalled in every final. Her teammate, Morgan Hurd, who had received a bronze medal for her efforts in the all-around competition and a gold with the American team, was clearly focused on what she had to do. She tumbled accurately whilst dancing with poise and polish to secure 13.933. By the time she had spotted her final tumble run, the double pike, she knew she had a very good chance of winning the silver medal, which she did. Meanwhile, the defending world champion Mai Murakami from Japan seemed happy to collect the bronze. But whilst they enjoyed the thrill of victory, Melnikova was feeling the agony of defeat, desperately upset with her fourth place finish. And what a lineup for the final on horizontal bar. Of the eight qualifying gymnasts, six had world titles to their names. Amongst them, 2017 world champion Tin Serbich, the Flying Dutchman Epke Zonderland, and the superb six times all-around world champion Koi Chimura. At 32, Epke Zonderland, who had held the title twice in the past, was back in tip-top form. They say fortune favours the daring. He upped his difficulty from 6.2 to 6.8, and the risk paid off. Maybe it was the additional motivation of wanting to take a medal home to his newborn baby boy. But the Flying Dutchman wowed the audience and the judges with spectacular exercise to score 15.1 and become world champion for the third time. Koei Uchimura from Japan was competing in his only individual final. Six times all-around world champion and twice all-around Olympic champion was the highest qualifier coming into the final. He performed a beautiful routine, executing the skills with his unique style, including a series of impressive release and regrasp elements, and finishing with a perfect landing to his double twisting double straight. He scored 14.8. In the end, his slightly lower difficulty value made the difference, and it was silver for Uchimura. So fortune favoured the daring on this final day of action. In a last turn of fate, Samuel Mikulak put his demons behind him and went clean to win the bronze medal. As we bid goodbye to Doha, we reflect on what a world championship it has been. Here are all of the results.
Together to thank all gymnasts.